Hey, y'all, I'm Brian Frix. I'm with Rockdale County DOT. We're in Georgia here. We're just outside the metropolitan Atlanta area. I'm a traffic and transportation engineer for the county, and I manage our pavement maintenance program and management program here. And have worked with many contractors in the past doing pavement preservation. What you see here behind me here is a high-density mineral bond project that we recently completed here this past month. Look down through here, you can kind of see some of the crack seal that we've got on the road here. What we did was we had our road crews come in and crack seal these roads and prepare these roads before the contractor came in to do the work. And then the contractor came and did the surface treatment on here. And basically this is a pavement preservation treatment that extends the life of our pavement, locks in the surface course, doesn't really provide any structural integrity for the roadway. So, you know, if you're looking for structural, you need to think asphalt. Any structural failures that we've had out here, we had to have our road guys come in and patch those areas. But for the most part, on a 0 to 100 scale, this road rated in low to mid-70s on a PCI. That's a pavement condition index. And so we've targeted a certain range of roads for pavement preservation. Again, on a 0 to 100 scale, those roads were about a 70 to an 85. And the upper 70s to low 85s is kind of the low 80s, I'm sorry. It's kind of what we targeted for the high-density mineral bond surface treatment. And so that's what you see here. And so again, we did a lot of the surface prep ourselves. If you're not able to do that, that's something that can be contracted out. That would be the crack seal. Many contractors around the U.S. that do that, they can come in, prepare your road beforehand, and then the contractor can come in and apply the high-density mineral bond surface treatment. So some of the challenges we face, well, we face many challenges, and again, that's a great question. So many times we are tasked with making sure we have enough of one particular treatment to pair up to a contract. So we've got to make sure we have an attractive quantity for the contractors to bid on competitively. Most importantly, we want to make sure that what we're doing is something that's going to be efficient and effective, and it's a proven technique. It's something that's going to last and perform as it should. So evaluation is another key part. So for our agency in particular, instead of embarking on a very large contract to begin with, we had the contractor come in and do a small pilot project, which was one road, and we've monitored that. And that kind of get our feet wet to show us what we could expect from the roadway. And then just meeting with different folks, the contractors and different agency people that have done this in the past and other industry experts that have knowledge of how this type of material performs, just to get comfortable with what we're doing. And that's a big part of it, is being comfortable knowing that what we're doing is going to perform and it has proven abilities to perform. And then, a part of that is convincing our commission staff and those that basically approve the funding for these that surface preservation is the way to go, pavement preservation is the way to go. Because essentially, when we build these roadways, the roadways start to deteriorate from day one. PCI starts to decline from 100 directly down. So each time we come in and do a pavement preservation treatment, we are increasing that PCI and extending the life of that pavement out for many years. So many pavements that are 15-year pavements, 15 or 20-year pavements, we're able to extend those pavements out, 25 years, 30 years, depending on, the ability of our staff to be able to secure the funding and for, the availability of the treatments in the area as well. Well, I would certainly encourage them to take a look at our roads or maybe some roads that are nearby to them. So the question was, I'm sorry, the question was what feedback would I give another agency if they approached me about this? Again, I would encourage them to take a look at our roads. I would encourage them to contact other agencies that have performed similar type of work with pavement preservation. you certainly need to have your pavements evaluated if you're not familiar with the condition of your pavements, because again, you want to make sure you're targeting the right pavement at the right time with the right treatment. And again, surface preservation, pavement preservation is not for every roadway. There's still a place for the rehabilitation. There's a place for the reconstruction. There's a place for overlays. And there's certainly a place for the pavement preservation. So you're going to need to know your condition of your roadways, condition of your pavements. So that's probably number one. And then number two, again, you know, get familiar and get comfortable with the treatment that you're looking at, and just talk to some of your colleagues in the industry to find out, you know, their experience with it. And I think you'll find that this particular treatment, most, if not all, have had very positive experiences with it, and can probably give very very positive references, very strong references for this material as well. This project had several residents that did call. Very rarely do we get positive feedback on roadway resurfacing. It's much more common that people call with complaints, even during construction, because they're inconvenienced. But we all know that you know, you're going to be slightly inconvenienced when you do have construction work going on. So this particular contract, we had very few calls that were negative. Most were very positive calls. You know, thanking us for coming in and doing this treatment on the roadway. If not all the phone calls we got were very positive, you know, regarding the work that was done and the contractor, you know, being very professional and assisting certain folks with special needs to get in and get out of the subdivision at certain times if they've had doctor's appointments or had an appointment or needed to be out for work-related issues or whatnot. So, you know, and they've accommodated the school system with the school buses here in the subdivision. So, you know, all in all, it went very well. And the contractor performed well, and the feedback we got from the citizens was very positive.